So, how do you think our MOOC started?
Well, I think it got onto a very good start, judging by the very interesting exchanges I see in the discussion section. I think there are some very, very relevant comments. There seems to be quite a lot of expertise in the participants to this short course.
Yeah, I completely agree. I also think there are a lot of backgrounds. So we talked a little bit about the CRM demand for future technologies. Can you maybe tell us a few sentences about that?
Well, I think we're really in the middle of it with a lot of talk in international meetings right now about the climate urgency, about decarbonizing the industry, getting out of fossil fuels. And so decarbonizing the demand for energy is really going to put a lot of pressure on the supply of these critical raw materials that are used in the renewable energy technologies like solar panels and wind power and simply the electricity grid for distributing all this. Because we often talk about special metals like rare earths or lithium and cobalt, etc. But simply copper is a main ingredient of distributing electricity in the grid, and demand for copper is going to really increase with this decarbonization of the energy supply.
Yeah, interesting that you mentioned copper. We actually had an exercise about the dynamics of resources and reserves, and I think there were a lot of discussions about this. Is there anything you want to add to these discussions?
Well, there's often the misunderstanding about the geological availability of these metals, where there's the common perception that we're going to run out. The risk is in fact the access to these metals. It's not actually how much is below our feet. The reserves is an economic term that's used in the mining industry to estimate the portion of resources identified by exploration campaigns, that portion of resources they can get out of the ground at a profit. So there's a lot of economic factors that enter into the definition of reserves. So it's something that's very extremely variable according to the situation, access. For example, if one country that has a monopoly on a certain metal closes its borders, then suddenly it becomes very critical. But it's very elastic. It depends. It interacts with prices, etc. If the reserves are down, then and there's a demand for the metal, then the mining industry will go back into a phase of exploration, and they'll discover new resources that will be transformed into reserves that are the economically extractable portion of the resources, and so the reserve base will increase. So it's really it's more a question of our access to these metals and how much is in the ground.
Thank you. Yeah, and I also saw a lot of really thoughtful comments regarding the potential of recycling and the question of energy use for extraction. And I think we can promise to our learners that we will address a lot of this in the coming week.
And, oh, yes. Yeah. Recycling is an essential component, yeah. And energy needed for extraction is a big issue because, as you know, the grades, the quality of the ores is going down because we've extracted what is the easiest to extract. And so you have to put in more energy to get the same amount of metal out of the ground. And that's a big issue because there's a point where it's no longer worth it. It's you have to put too much energy and at a too high cost for it to be worth it economically.
So thanks, Dominique.
You're welcome.
And I think everybody, we see each other next week, and enjoy the rest of the course.
Thank you, Alyssa. Bye-bye.
Bye.